Hi, it's Phil from Delphi, and in today's how-to video, we're going to look at how do we test knock sensors. Now, knock sensors, they're actually quite a difficult sensor to test. In fact, in the Delphi Online Academy, we have a whole module dedicated to how knock sensors operate and how they should be tested. But in this video, I'm going to give you a quick summary of how to easily check and test your knock sensor. So we're underneath this 2021 Kia Sportage. And what we're going to look at is on the online technical data, what does this vehicle have in terms of knock sensors and what kind of pinouts do we have that we're able to actually test? Now I'm going to be using the Delphi technical data. It's called VTI. And we're going to start off with, we can either enter registration number or VIN number. And I can see that it's a Kia Sportage with a 1.6 diesel engine. So from there, we can go to electronics. And I can go to engine systems, and I'm presented with four options. Two are with automatic transmission, and two are with manual. Now, since this is a manual, that's what I'm going to go for. And the only other choice is with or without smart key. Now, this vehicle has a traditional key, doesn't have a smart key, so we can click that and then move on to electronic systems. Now, if we scroll down the list, we can find knock sensors towards the bottom. And I've actually got two options on knock sensors. We've got behind the diesel particulate filter, which on this is right at the front, right near the exhaust manifold, or behind the SCR catalytic converter, which is this item here. So I'm going to click on the one behind the diesel particulate filter. So you've kind of got one pre and post SCR cat, and that brings me into the wiring diagram. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to expand on the diagram, and from that I can see that this particular sensor has five wires. We have a power supply coming into the knock sensor controller. We have two earth connections and we have a can high and can low. So what sort of testing are we going to do? The first check is we're going to test the live to it and we're going to test the two earths to make sure they are reading correctly. Once we've ascertained that those two are correct, we can then move to testing the can high and can low connections directly to the knock sensor controller. Now on this, to gain access to the controllers, they're actually under this panel. So I'm just going to zip this panel off to give us that access that we need. I've got the Pico Scope set up on the DS480 and we're using the Pico here. Now this is the later generation where we can just plug the lead in and it will auto recognize which cable that we're using. So we're going to go in here on channel A, which is the blue light. So I'm going to select the blue lead just to make things a little bit easier for when you're running multiple channels. So we're going to go in first and connect the blue lead. That's connected. And as I said, we're first going to check the live and the earth. So live first, we're going to connect into a known body earth. Make sure we're not picking an earth point that's potentially got a lot of paint on it, because this will disrupt our readings. Now on this sensor, when we go back to the diagram to have a quick look, I can see that the first pin, pin number one, is my live connection. Now I've got the ignition on. Of course, with the ignition on, you may not get a signal. And I'm going to go in with one of the dedicated pin checkers and click into there. And we're looking for a nice 12 volt, which I can see here straight away, that's 12 volt. Now, if it was less than that, let's say about 10 or 10 and a half volt, then I would look at what's causing that volt drop within the system. And this may be the cause of my knock sensor error. So that one there is looking pretty good. I'm going to now move to my earth point. Now to do that, there are a few different ways of checking earths. I'm going to disconnect it from my known earth point, and I'm going to use the two earth points on the sensor. If I get a different reading from the one I've just got, I know I've potentially got an earth problem. So let's go in the first one. Remember on this sensor, there were two earths. This was pin two and pin five. So the next pin along into pin two, and I'm getting that same level of voltage, no difference, no voltage drop I can see from the screen. So I know that that earth point's okay. On to pin five, exactly the same. So on this sensor, I know that the voltage supply looks good and the two earth points look good with no volt drop along the system. I'm going to get a second cable now, and I'm going to be able to check the two can signals, can high and can low, to the knock sensor controller. And then we're going to have a look to see if those readings are correct. Right, I'm going to move that back to my known earth point, and then I'm going to move this pin over to the from the earth into the first can connection. I'm going to get my next lead because, of course, we've got two channels. So we've got a can high and a can low. Just make sure there are no kinks in the wire. And I'm going to connect in my next channel. There we go. We can just drop that into the earth. And I'm going to pull my next connection into pin four. Pin three and four were can high, can low. Now the connections are incorrectly. We can see that we have two very nice can traces, the can high and can low. And remembering that the engine ECU will be talking to the NOx controller separately and taking all the data directly from the sensor, from the two NERNT cells within the sensor, which will be transmitted onto the NOx controller. The NOx controller will modify the data then to a digital binary signal, which is being sent over CAN to the main engine controller. Now, as a technician, that might sound all complicated, but what is it you actually need to check? We're going through the results now. What we're going to do is we're going to stop, and we're going to do a little bit of analyzing. So I'm just going to rewind it back, and you can see here there I've got a very nice CAN trace. I'm going to take a zoom in. I'm going to take a snapshot of a zoom into there, and we can see that I can move this up and down and just align the two CAN traces together. Now, traditionally, what we're looking at on this particular NOx sensor CAN trace is that the two peaks should total around 5 volt. So let's take a look at that now. We're going to grab the measurement pins, bring that down to the first one, and we can see that that's coming in there at 1.382 volts. We're going to grab the red one, exactly the same, and we're coming in there, and that one there is 3.614 volts. If you add those two numbers together, perfect. We're getting around that 5 volt mark. So we know here that we haven't got any high resistances, any shorts to live. These are the common CAN faults we're going to get. We're going to get a short to the body, potentially in the wiring or in the NOx controller. We're going to get a short to live, in which case the one of the CAN wires or both of them could just read a high voltage. Or of course, as I said there, we have a short together. So those are your three faults. Short to live, short to earth, and short together. Those are the main reasons, really, why we're going to be getting NOx sensor faults. Of course, if the NOx controller diagnoses a fault with the NOx sensor directly, perhaps the heater element, or there's a short in one of the NERNT cells, then that's really where you're going to need to look at your fault code reader rather than rely on the scope data. Thanks for watching. For more videos, then why not follow us on social media or visit the Masters of Motion online hub. And for more expert-led courses, visit us online at the Delphi Academy. See you next time.